Hello everybody, this is Paloma Ramirez and I'm here to tell you about my learning experience when I was learning English at King's School. I remember that it wasn't that boring and stressing learning environments where you have to learn everything by heart, like memorizing, repeating and imitating the teacher, etc. This was more like a participative class. The teacher gave us the instances to speak about other cultures, other people, you know, other countries, and we have the opportunity to interact with my classmates and the students, and also with the teacher. I had also the opportunity to speak without being afraid of my pronunciation, because teachers always told me that making mistakes was just part of my own learning process. And most importantly, teachers gave me this great opportunity to realize that I wanted to become an English teacher. I wanted to give people this great opportunity of learning another language, to communicate with others, you know, to interact with people from other countries outside, you know, Chile, and to understand other cultures, to understand other people, and among many, 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 many benefits from learning English. So, indeed, English teaching at King's School is a radical and innovative way of learning and teaching English. Bye!
Concepción is the second biggest city in Chile, and it's a big brand. Modern place with lots of activities you can do and place you can visit. Where is the city? Concepción is the locate.
Banana pancake, ingredient, flour, milk, salt, butter, egg, and banana.
It's very important hand washing.
First, we will cut the banana and grind it.
2 minutes más tarde.
Next, pour a little butter in the pan. Finally, make the pancake necessary. Serve them with honey for your breakfast.
Very good.
Delicious.
No, I won't
wash the dishes.
Friends, welcome to the world of My Little Pony. Come on!
My little pony, my little pony.
My name is Maite Magic. And today I will teach you how to cook rainbow hotcakes. Let's go!
Remember, 30 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 30.
Ingredients: 1 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of almond milk, 2 tablespoons tea activate, 1 kiwi, 1 banana. 2 tangerine, 4 strawberries. Step. Your kitchen off for you. Put the pan and let it heat. With the help of an adult, he watches, peel and chop the fruit. Ta-da! Put the hotcakes on a tray. Thank you.
Hello, how are you today? My name is Fernanda Salona, 7th grade. Name of my dish is palta reina. Ingredients: 1 avocado, 1 cilantro, oil, 1 tomato, salt and lemon. Preparation: for this recipe, we in a medium avocado. Free with the help of my mom, we cook it in hot. Second, and salt, lemon, cilantro, and mayo to the tuna. Next, and we put the help of avocado. Finally, I use tomato for the decoration of my dish.
Hello, my name is Anaís Gómez. Concepción is the second biggest city in Chile, and it's a vibrant, modern place with lots of activities you can do and place you can visit. Where is the city?
Hola a todos, mi nombre es Manuela Méstica y junto con las profesoras Celeste Peña, la profesora Patricia Urrea y la profesora Natalia Sepúlveda conformamos lo que es el equipo de inglés del Colegio King School Cordillera.
Today we make a breakfast for summer. The ingredients we will need for 2 persons are 4 oranges, 1 apple, 1 cup of oat, 1 yogurt, honey, and optional some sugar. First, put an apple in a mixer. Second, when it's ready, add a cup of oat and honey and steal. Next, add yogurt and put it on a cup. Then, squeeze in oranges. Optional, add some sugar. After that, put it on a cup. Finally, taste it and enjoy. Okay, first the juice. Yum yum, now the oat. Delicious! Okay, bye-bye.
Hi, my name is Pamama and I'm going to talk about natural disasters. Wildfire and earthquake. Earthquake. An earthquake, also known as quake or tremor, is the result of a sudden release in the Earth's crust. We measure earthquake with a seismograph. If an earthquake is of magnitude 3 or lower, it can be very harmless, but earthquakes of magnitude 7 or higher can be very harmful and cause serious damage over large areas of land. Wildfire. Wildfire is an uncontrolled fire that normally occurs in countryside and wilderness, where you can find combustible vegetation. Wildfires can cause extensive damage to property, land, and human life.
It's the 7:10. Every beautiful time is already sung. And I go write this another one. So your melody will play on and on. But the best for them, you are beautiful. Like a dream come alive, incredible. A wonderful miracle. You say I love a game, and I want to, you know, baby.
Bueno, mi nombre es Celeste Peña. Soy la profesora de inglés del ciclo séptimo a segundo medio este año. y es primera vez que a nivel colegio hacemos este workshop. Queremos nosotros explicar en español lo que hemos trabajado con mis colegas durante estos últimos años. Esta oportunidad que se nos dio de parte del cambio de actividades que tenemos que hacer. Entonces ustedes ya han ido viendo parte de las primeras procesos que los chicos llevan acá. Especialmente se ven beneficiados cuando parten de pequeñitos con nosotros en King School. Ellos de a poquitito empiezan a trabajar recetas, cuidado, por ejemplo, lavado de manos, cosas pequeñitas que tienen que ellos empezar a hacer, hasta presentaciones, actuaciones, dramatizaciones, trabajar durante meses, involucrarse en cursos, en culturas, en costumbres y tratar con esas costumbres, vivirlas. Ellos también tienen, se han visto en la necesidad de aprender el trabajo en equipo. Nosotros, como un equipo, como el Departamento de Inglés, hemos querido trabajar con ellos el desarrollo de estas habilidades blandas que son base para el futuro laboral y el éxito de la sociedad de hoy en día. Ustedes van a ver más adelante videos de exalumnos nuestros con distintos estudios, distintos futuros, y cómo el inglés ha sido una herramienta esencial y útil para ellos. Chicos que se han formado o toda su enseñanza media acá o desde pequeñitos acá. Y se han sentido parte de este proyecto que trabajamos como colegas. Principalmente el trabajo en equipo es una herramienta esencial. No solamente el inglés, sino que aprenden a delegarse el trabajo y sienten la responsabilidad de cada uno cumplir con su parte al 100.
Una de las características principales del equipo de inglés es que trabajamos siempre en equipo y somos súper competitivos. Pero en el buen sentido de la palabra. Nosotros siempre queremos destacar y queremos hacer las cosas bien. Y constantemente estamos buscando nuevas formas de poder enseñar el idioma inglés, porque a todos nosotros nos gusta mucho lo que hacemos, queremos y valoramos mucho nuestro trabajo, y por eso estamos constantemente tratando de innovar en lo que es la enseñanza en inglés.
Organizing your study is one of the most effective study skills. And ironically, also one of the most often overlooked. Creating a study timetable gives you goals and a responsibility and sets the time in which to study. Having a study timetable as you study is greatly motivational. In short, we can use any of the above techniques to help make our study process more effective and easier. You can choose any of them depending on the type of result that you want to achieve. There are no right to wrong study techniques. You just select the one that is the most adequate for your purpose. Some of them are better to study sets at least. Others help us organize our habits better, while others simply provide us with the correct ideas.
Kathleen of Aragon employee. He had to leave the Catholic Church to marry her. She had Elizabeth the First and then was accused by adultery and was beheaded. In this image, you can check this character and when was beheaded.
Jane Seymour was the employee of Hamlet and was the third wife that he had.
She gave him a boy named Edward. Good afternoon, teacher. Based on my experience, I think that as teenagers, when applying for a part-time job, we are attracted to the idea of generating our own money without feeling dependent on spending it. We can also provide basic resources at home.
In my opinion, as I see it, it's very beneficial for me. Why? Because, as you can see, it could help me to organize my time. I also could improve my body language, the way I've expressed myself, and let me generate funds. In other words, it's gonna helps me in my own development.
If I have the chance to meet one person dead or alive, I would like to meet with my nephews Benjamin and Alonso, because it's been a long time since I last saw them. I have always been close to them, and due to personal issues, I haven't seen them since long before the quarantine started, and I miss them very much.
Hi there, I am Alexandre, and today I will answer the question of what I would like to change of the world today. Well, in my case, I would like to stop the global warming, because in my opinion, it's leading us to an unstoppable combination: massive extinction of animal species, desertification of fertile soil, and the deglaciation of the poles. If we don't stop at time, maybe this generation will be the last generation to know this world with vegetation and life.
And if I could meet a person dead or alive, I think I would like to be able to meet director Hayao Miyazaki, because I am really a fan of his beautiful films and characters. But this also brings to mind Joe Hisaishi, who is a very famous composer. I would also love to meet him because I love the music he makes and his words that are simple, beautiful. There are many such talented people that I would like to meet, but I will say that these two are more some of the ones that I would like the most. If I could have a superpower, I would like to be able to control time and stop it at my whim, because I would like to have a power like this is because in this time of quarantine, I have realized how sometimes time goes by without releasing it, and I felt how many books will there be in the world, how many songs or movies that I have not yet seen, and without my years of life, I will probably not get to know half of them. So I thought I wish I had more time and could read more, listen more, and know more. It's a bit of a strange reason, but I think it would really be great to have more time to learn.
I will kick at bat. Too late!
A few moments later.
Baby, 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 woo! Baby, 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 woo!
The deodorant is very important. If we did not take the deodorant, we smell bad. Okay, what time is it? Oh my god, I'm late! Case, I left you here yesterday.
You are a stupid.
Cheer up, Batman. Case.
Are you crazy?
It's the hour of tea.
Like fear and love are carried out by the limbic system, which is located in the temporal lobe. While the limbic system is made up of multiple parts of the brain, the center of emotional processing is amygdala, which receives input from other brain functions like memory and attention. Thank you.
a set of brain structures located on both sides of the thalamus immediately beneath the cerebellum. It has also been referred to as the paleomalian cortex. The limbic system supports a variety of functions, including emotion, behavior, motivation, long-term memory, and olfaction.
The primary structure, the within the limbic system, include amygdala, hippocampus, thalamus, hypothalamus, basal ganglia, and the cingulate gyrus. The amygdala is the emotion center of the brain, while the hippocampus plays an essential role in the formation of the new memories about past experience.
Finally, through in the limbic system, the limbic system connection of many brain structures that have control emotions and addiction to memory, learning, motivation, and bodily function, like appetite and sex drive. Support and the limbic system include the hippocampus, amygdala, and hypothalamus.
Scientists have identified a special region of the brain called the amygdala as the part of the brain that processes fear, triggers anger, and motivates us to act. It alerts us to danger and activates the fight or flight response.
Important because it controls behavior essential to life, such as the desire to eat and drink. The cingulate gyrus is located in the fold in the brain and involved on sensory input for the motion of the weight, aggressive behavior. The diencephalon includes the thalamus and hypothalamus.
Hello there, and welcome to the teaser trailer for our presentation, Heart Squads. Today, we're gonna show the basic aspects of our show that's gonna take on next Tuesday. Let's review the basics.
Atherosclerosis is a disease in which plaque grafts inside in your arteries. Plaque is a sticky substance made up of hard cholesterol, calcium, and other substances forming the blood. Over time, plaque hardens and narrows your arteries, that delimits flow of oxygen-rich blood to your body.
Atherosclerosis can lead to problem using coronary artery disease. These arteries supply blood to your heart. When they are blocked, you can engineer your heart attack. Coronary disease This is artery sucking blood to your brain. When they are broken, you can suffer a broken.
Peripheral arterial disease. These arteries are in your arms, legs, and pelvis. When they are blocked, you can suffer from numbness, pain, and sometimes infections.
Atherosclerosis usually doesn't cause symptoms until it's severe and normal or totally abrupt an artery. Many people don't know they have it, would think they have a medical emergency.
Causes: hardening of the arteries often occurs with a gait. As you grow older, plaque buildup narrows your arteries and makes them stiffer. This change makes it harder for blood to flow through them.
Close my parenthesis, narrow arteries and block blood flow. Pieces of plaque can also break off and move it to smaller blood vessels, blocking them.
Dislocate the star tissue of blood and oxygen. This can result in damage or tissue death. It's a common cause of heart attack and stroke.
High blood cholesterol levels can cause hardening of the arteries at a young age. For many people, high cholesterol levels are due to a diet that is too high saturated fats and trans fats.
We'll see you on next Tuesday on our STEM. We hope you like it. See you there.
A bailar y así la gente lo haga.
No, 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 no,
no, no. ¿Qué estamos haciendo? Ay,
sí, yo, ahí, claro.
Sí, ahí por tercero.
¡Ah, ya voy yo! ¡Ya comprando igual!
¡Ah, ya lo no estoy
comprando!
¡Ay, así! ¡Ya habrá dale!
¡Muchas gracias!
Por último, les quiero comentar que nosotros, la profesora Patricia, la profesora Celeste, la profesora Natalia y yo, siempre estamos preocupados de que ustedes aprendan, chiquillos, de que ustedes aprendan correctamente el idioma que a nosotros tanto nos gusta y de que sean unos profesionales de excelencia. Por eso los invito a involucrarse con inglés, a participar en las obras de teatro, películas, canciones, recetas, todas las locuras que se nos ocurran a nosotros. Porque esas locuras que se nos ocurran a nosotros son las locuras que también a ustedes se les ocurren. Ustedes son súper participativos y son estudiantes de excelencia y queremos que lo sepan.
También decidimos, como equipo del departamento de inglés, colocar algunos videos selectos de los años anteriores. De hace 2 años atrás, cuando los estudiantes tuvieron que hacer presentaciones en inglés para el técnico, para la semana técnico profesional. Y también entrevistamos a exalumnos. Tenemos varios videos también de presentaciones que los chicos han trabajado. O sea, no es ninguna presentación especial para este día de workshop de Speaking Skills. Esta presentación que se está haciendo ahora son recopilaciones de lo que hemos trabajado este año, pese a la distancia, a la pandemia, y también videos que hemos trabajado de los años anteriores, que le pedimos participación a los estudiantes de repetir el video, de volver a hacerlo, algo que ellos estudiaron, internalizaron, trabajaron, memorizaron y que pudieran compartirlo nuevamente a la comunidad educativa. Así que quiero agradecer a todos aquellos estudiantes que participaron, que mostraron sus ganas, que se atrevieron a hacerlo. Y ese es un gran paso adelante, porque lo único que queremos nosotros, sus profesores, es ver el éxito en ustedes, porque el éxito de ustedes también es parte del nuestro y queremos construir con ustedes, guiarlos, orientarlos para un éxito que ustedes decidan, que ustedes se determinan. Nosotros estaremos ahí para ayudarlos. Congratulations.